colleagues and students. Today, I'm going to present before you a very brief paper. You might say a basic paper on how to correlate and use visual images, miniatures, etc., which are regarding the buildings. In fact, we know that the Mughals, when they came to India, they introduced two schools of art. One, the Mughal architecture, and second, the school of paintings. It is generally believed, and it's also true, that as a school, the Mughal contributions started developing from the period of Akbar onwards. And that is why we say that it is from the period of Akbar that there was a distinct Mughal school of painting and there was a Mughal school of architecture. When we talk about Mughal school of architecture and Mughal school of painting, that they started with the reign of Akbar, that doesn't mean that there was no architecture or painting in the earlier periods of the Mughal reign. We know that when Babur comes to India, he brought with him not only the soldiers, but he also brought with him a number of artists and architects. In fact, there are at least two architects who entered into India along with Babur. One of them, Mirak Mirza Ghayas, not only constructed structures during the reign of Babur, a brief reign of Babur, he also kept on working during the period of Humayun, but ultimately he went on to contribute what today we know as the Humayun's Maqbara. Along with that, as I said, that the Mughals also came to India along with a number of artists. Professor S.P. Verma, who has written much on paintings, miniatures and art, he in one of his articles points out how during the reign of Humayun, once at a time when Humayun was fleeing from the country, when he had been hosted by the Afghans, by Sher Shah, Sher Khan in fact, and while he was returning back, he had nothing along with him, no army, no people, no money. In fact, there was also a paucity of horses. Mahamanaga didn't have a horse, and Humayun had to request one of his nobles to lend a horse for her, and he had refused. Even in such periods of time, he was accompanied by an artist, because it is recorded in one of the sources that once after taking bath, when he entered his camp, he found that a bird had entered into the tent. Humayun ordered the door of the tent to be closed and asked the artist to come and make a painting of that particular bird. So we know that the Mughals, whether it was Babur or Humayun, they were very much interested in both these arts. Right? So, but then it was only under Akbar that both these traditions were formalized. Before I come to the topic which I am supposed to be dealing here, I would also like to inform my students that both these schools, whether it was the Mughal school of miniatures, paintings, or Mughal school of architecture, both these things had nothing distinct which can be labeled as Mughal. Whether it was the art or the architecture, they were all borrowed traditions, borrowed from various sources, various traditions which existed by the time of Akbar himself, whether they were Iranian traditions, Central Asian traditions, or they were the traditions which had come into existence during the Sultanate period in various regions of the country, all of them were taken together. The only thing was that the Mughal architect and the artist knew how to mix all these things together. So, in short, the Mughal schools, where you may now find features from Iranian traditions, features from Central Asian traditions, and so on and so forth, being reflected in all these productions, whether on paper, whether on skin, whether in the form of stone. All these traditions started, in fact, developing in right earnest from the period of Akbar onwards. And it was during the period of Akbar that a Mughal atelier of both were established. And in both these ateliers, one thing very distinct, there were two things distinct, but one thing which I would mention first is that there was collaborative work. In one particular painting, for example, there would be a number of artists which would be executing it. Similarly, in the building also, we find that if the architect, the superintendent, the daroga was a Central Asian, then the masons and others were all indigenous people. And we have the evidence of these stone masons' marks, which tell us that the work, the execution of the buildings, they were carried out by the local indigenous people. This is not the time to inform you, but we do not find even a single signature of a Muslim mason as far as the period of Akbar or the period of Jahangir or Shah Jahan is concerned. Most of the, and all these names which have been written, they are in Devanagari. So the persons who executed the work, they were all indigenous people, whereas those who planned it, they were Central Asians. That is why the amalgamation came into existence. Now, as far as this theme is concerned, there has been much controversy whether, because I am going to deal with you with the question whether the paintings can be used as a source for history or not. Is there a relation between what is being painted in a book or on paper with the building itself? There is a scholar, Ebakosh. Almost all of you who have studied Mughal architecture, they must have heard this name. Ebakosh is one of the very prominent historians of Mughal art. And she, although has written a number of books, but I feel that her specialization is on the period of Shah Jahan. So basically, when she looks at those miniatures and things, they are Shah Jahan. Now, she argues in a number of works that these paintings, these illustrations, whether they are in the form of miniature on books or they are in, on the structures themselves, they are all idealized. They cannot be taken as photographic evidence. She goes on to argue that the buildings might have been executed at a time when these artists were not allowed to enter these buildings. They were not knowing what exactly is out there, and so it is their perception which is being reflected there. So they are all idealized images and they cannot be taken as authentic evidence at all. It is how the artist feels that things would have been, and that is what he has drawn. She goes on to argue in a number of seminars. She tried to argue with me and I contested with her. And that was that these are all, you know, art, works of art. And art, works of art cannot be taken on the face. So this is a question that she answers, that they are, these paintings, they are not realistic at all. But then my work suggests otherwise. I will be presenting to you a few sites where I have worked, and I will try to relate with you how these miniatures can be used to interpret Tibetans. Before I go to that, let me also inform you that when we talk about miniatures and when we talk about monuments, there are two types of relationships, which I have already mentioned, but let me elaborate it once again. And that is that there are miniatures in the books where certain structures are depicted. For example, there are scenes from Agra Fort, there are scenes from Fatehpur Sikri Palace, there are scenes from Allahabad, and so on and so forth. And they are all in the form of book illustrations. So you pick up Akbarnama, for example, Victoria Albert Museum, you will find the depiction of all those palaces and buildings which are said to have been constructed during the period of Akbar. You pick up Padshahnama, and there you would find the illustrations which ideally belong to the period of Shah Jahan. So there is an illustration by an artist where buildings are being reproduced. But then, on the other hand, there is another set, and that set is that there are a number of illustrations, sometimes individual paintings, sometimes in the form of portraits, sometimes in the form of miniature panels, which are given on the surface of the building itself. So there are two types of relationships. One, building being depicted in the painting. On the other, a painting being illustrated on the walls of the structure themselves. So there are two types of evidences which we have to correlate with. Now here, for example, we have an image from the Victoria Albert Museum, Akbarnama. Here, there is a scene of the Diwan-e-Aam, which is depicted by an artist. The signature of the artist is also given there, Amal-e-Hussain, and Chehra-e-Nami, Kesav. Chehra means the portraiture, and Amal means the sketch. So there are two artists, as I said, that there was a collaborative work. One artist making the sketches, second painting, third making the faces of the people depicted out there. And this particular painting depicts a scene where Akbar is sitting in the Diwan-e-Aam at Fatehpur Sikri. Right? Now, if you go to Fatehpur Sikri now, there is no minaret which is there in the whole complex. The minaret is also not there even in the Jama Masjid of Fatehpur Sikri. Kahin pe bhi koi minaret Fatehpur Sikri pe nahi hai. But then you look there on the top, the painting depicts a minaret. Abakosh would say ke this is an idealized image. Mughal period mein minarets bante the. So artist ne, kyunki Sikri mein nahi bana raha tha baith ke, he was making it at a time when the court was in Lahore. So because the artist probably never visited Fatehpur Sikri, so he made the minaret. So this is what her contention is. There is another image in the same Akbarnama, another illustration where once again the Diwan-e-Aam is being depicted. Again, we find that there is a certain noble who is bringing in prisoners wearing animal skins. It was a tradition that when they would be caught, they would be attired in tied into with animal skins and then brought humiliated before the emperor. So again, it is Diwan-e-Aam. But then, and you can find that the so-called Dhodabai Palace, if you go to photo, a scene where if you, even today when you go to Fatehpur Sikri, if you stand in the Diwan-e-Aam and look towards the palatial complex, you would find that just behind the Diwan-e-Aam, you will find that there is the so-called Jodhpur Palace, which is depicted here. And now besides Jodhpur Palace, again there is a minaret. So there are two paintings, contemporary to Akbar, contemporary to the period when Fatehpur Sikri actually existed, and in both these miniatures, there is a minaret which has been depicted. And if you go to the site, there is no minaret. Abakosh argued that ye sab artist ke apna khayal tha. Artist to khula aadmi hai, jo chahe bana de usse bana diya. But then, if you read Mullah Abdul Qadir Badaini, the text of Mullah Abdul Qadir Badaini, if you read Arif Kandhari, Tariq Kandhari or Tariq Akbari. In fact, if you go and read Akbarnama itself, there is a description of an episode. There, it is said that a mendicant, a Sufi, came to Akbar's court and he claimed that he can build an underground chamber surrounded with water. Water would not enter into that chamber and he can go inside this chamber without getting wet. And while describing this, Badaini and Abul Fazal and Arif Kandhari, all of them tell us that on the top of the chamber in this water tank, there was a Minare Buland which was raised, a high tower which was raised. When was it demolished? We do not know. But in all the contemporary sources, you get evidence that there was a minara. And in the Akbarnama paintings, you get that minaret at the exact spot which is being mentioned by the sources. Bilkul jahan pe Diwan-e-Aam hai aur Jodhpur Palace hai, usi ke piche wahi. Agar aap aaj wahan jayenge, to there is there is a tank out there, Anoop Talao. Probably it was at that particular site, we are not very sure. But as per the information of the sources, so one can say that paintings are in fact authenticating the information which is given by sources like Mullah Abdul Qadir Badaini and Arif Kandhari. Right? Now in my book on Fatehpur Sikri, I have similarly used a number of such paintings to interpret a number of structures. I personally believe that some of these Mughal miniatures are very, very photographic in nature. In fact, from some of these miniatures of the Akbarnama, whether they are in Victoria Albert Museum or whether they are in the Akbarnama at the Dublin Museum, you can also go on to prove when a particular structure was built. For example, there is another painting, but I'm not sure whether I have brought it here or not. No, that is not there. In which a half-built Fatehpur Sikri is being depicted. And if you want to have a look at that, there is a book by S.N. Jan Kaiser, A.J. Kaiser, Building Construction During the Period of the Mughals. There he has reproduced it in black and white, where a half-constructed Fatehpur Sikri is there, and you can see which portion has been built and which is still under construction. If you look at the dates given in the sources, they tally with this information. So artist jab bana raha hai, wo sirf apne khay. Dekhiye artist kab banayega? Jo cheez dekhega, us cheez ko dekh ke banayega. Aaj main aapse kahunga ki aap ek bandook bana dijiye, to aap kaun si bandook banayenge? Wahi bandook banayenge jo aapne dekhi hogi. Aap wo bandook nahi banayenge jo Akbar ke period mein istemal hoti thi. Right? So there must be something, there must be an existence of something, only then the artist would be depicting it. Right? Now, for example, in this painting here, there is a fully built, main entry to the palace complex, the Hathi Pole or Fatehpur Sikri. You can see the waterworks. The Persian wheels at different levels. Today, if you go to the site, there are only wells. How water was drawn from there? it is only through these paintings that you come to know how, through various stages, the water was raised from this level and brought to that level. Number one. Number two, we also come to know that along this main passage, which is the royal passage, because there is an accompanying painting along with it, in which Emperor Akbar himself is shown entering into the palace complex. It's a two-page painting. I'm only showing you the first page of that. Akbar sahab enter kar rahe hain, isliye wo royal entry ka ye kehlata hai. Lekin isme aap dekhenge ye hathi pose hai, life size elephants. Yahan kaun baitha? The pan sellers. So in my book, I tried to write that there was a thriving market in this area. And I was authenticated by certain excavations which have taken place in the last 2 or 3 years by ASI at Fatehpur Sikri. Jab inhone Hathipol ke samne debris clean kiya hai, to ye jo tabutre hai aur jahan upar ye shops bani hui hai, now they have been excavated. If you look behind this Hathipol, again ek teen dar ka ek structure bana hua hai jahan shopkeepers baithe hue. ये सेकंड गेट है हाथीपोल से मुड़ के जब जो आपको दीवाने आम की तरफ ले जाएगा और वहां पे फिर एक दुकान है जिसपे बैठ के लोग सामान बेच रहे हैं. ड्यूरिंग द एक्सकैवेशंस व्हिच वर डन बाय प्रोफेसर आर सी गौर इन 80s वी फाउंड सच अ स्ट्रक्चर. उसमें भी तीन ही दर हैं, बिल्कुल उसी अंदाज का बना हुआ. ये मैंने फोटो ली थी हिरण मीनार पे खड़े होकर. नेचुरली द हाथी पोल इज सच अ मॉन्यूमेंटल स्ट्रक्चर, इसके पीछे का नजर नहीं आता, लेकिन इसमें वाटर वर्क्स एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स, पीछे का सीन आपको इसमें डिपिक्टेड नहीं. लेकिन पीछे जो एक्सकैवेशंस में जो आर सी गौर साहब ने एक्सकैवेट किया था, वही तीन दर का. आप ये पेंटिंग देखिए और ये स्ट्रक्चर देखिए, यहां सेकेंड गेट, यहां पे हाथी को चबूतरा, चबूतरे के पीछे दर वाला स्ट्रक्चर जो दुकान.
आर्टिस्ट हो सकता है लाहौर में बैठा होगा, लेकिन उसने जो सीन जो डिपेक्ट किया है, ये बिल्कुल ऐसा किया जैसे फोटोग्राफ खींच रहा हूं. तो जो चीज हमें पेंटिंग में मिली थी वही एक्सकैवेशन में प्रूव हो जाती है. इन अदर वर्ड्स, कम अज कम एटलीस्ट अकबरनामा पेंटिंग्स आर वेरी वेरी फोटोग्राफिक इन नेचर. दे आर रियलिस्टिक एंड वन कैन नॉट बिलीव व्हाट एबाकॉश इज ट्राइंग टू से, दैट दे आर ओनली आइडियलिस्टिक. आइडियलिज्म जरूर होगा, जाहिर है, वन कैन नॉट डिनाई दे आर नॉट फोटोग्राफ्स. तो बिल्कुल वैसे ही दर्द नहीं होगा, उतना ही चौड़ा सा बड़ा सा चबूतरा नहीं होगा, अलग अंदाज का होगा. हर आर्टिस्ट अपने अंदाज में बनाएगा, दैट इज अ गिवन फैक्ट. लेकिन चीज थी तो वहां बनाई गई, मौजूद थी तो बनाया गया, बन रही थी अभी तैयार नहीं हुई थी, हाफ कंस्ट्रक्टेड बिठाया गया, राइट. सो एट लीस्ट देन सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, आई एम सॉरी मैम इफ आई एम टेकिंग योर टाइम, द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल आई विल गिव फ्रॉम द पीरियड ऑफ जहांगीर. नाउ दिस इज अ पेंटिंग विच बिलोंग्स टू पीरियड ऑफ जहांगीर, द सन ऑफ अकबर. हियर देयर इज अ गार्डन सीन in which a woman, an empress or a paramour, whosoever it is shown entertaining Jahangir, sitting before a pavilion, and behind the pavilion there is a river. We know that Noor Jahan Begum, the wife of Jahangir, renovated a garden which is said to have been originally constructed by Babur. General perception, jo common legend hai, wo ye hai ki ek garden Babur ke period ka tha, which was known as, which is now known as Alam Bagh. Legend goes that after Babur's death, he was temporarily interned into this garden before his body was transported to Kabul. And that was this garden which later on during the period of Jahangir became the property of Noor Jahan, who renovated it and gave it the name of Bagh-e-Noor-Afsham. Today, there is a garden at Agra. As soon as you enter Agra from Aligarh, you will find this garden, which is now known as Rambagh. Aram ka corruption. Now, my student Abdullah, who is sitting here, he doesn't believe that the Babur's garden, Aram Bagh, was the same as the Bagh-e-Noor-Afsham of Jahangir. It says you, he is free to have his view, but it is my firm conviction on the basis of this painting that this is the same garden. When you go to Aram Bagh today or Bagh-e-Noor-Afsham, you will find the river flowing behind with such pavilions out there. And now pay attention to what is depicted on the walls surface of the pavilion itself, behind Jahangir.
There's decorated surfaces. The painting is not very clear from where you are sitting. There is a Jesus and a Mary. Isme clear nahi hai aapko.
Lekin uspe ek taraf Mother Mary depicted hai, ek taraf Jesus depicted.
इसमें शायद आप क्लियर होगा जीसस यहाँ पे और पेंटिंग है ऊपर
वो डिपेक्टेड वही बाग है वही पवेलियन है जब मैं गया था आई हैड विजिटेड दिस प्लेस इन 1990s लॉन्ग टाइम बैक एंड व्हेन आई विजिटेड द प्लेस देयर वाज अ ब्रिटिश पीरियड वाइट वॉश So my team, which was with me from the archaeology section of the department, they have all retired now. One of them, I said, "Ke yahan ye milna chahiye paintings thi, ab to yahan pe safai chuna hai, kuch bhi nahi hai." To unme se ek saab ne kaha ki saab chune ki khasiyat ye hoti hai ki geela kijiye to wo translucent ho jata hai. To ek tarkeeb karte hain. Hum balti lai gayi, balti mein pani bhara gaya, balti mein pani bhar ke us pe dala. और जैसे ही डाला गया पीछे से नहीं फिर हम लोगों ने क्या किया कि तो वो तो दो मिनट को निकली थी और फिर वो एकदम से जज्ब हो गया पानी खत्म हो गई सो व्हाट वी डिड वाज कि हमने कैमरा सेट किया स्टैंड पे लगाया एक आदमी उसके पीछे खड़ा हुआ एक बाल्टी लेके खड़ा हुआ मैंने 1, 2, 3 बोलना शुरू किया और जैसे 3 किया उन्होंने पानी फेंका और जैसे उन्होंने क्लिक किया रिजल्ट वाज दिस A man with a beard comes out immediately. Now, if you go to the same garden, through renovation works which have been done there, that white has been removed. Now it is visible there. The only difference is कि इसमें अभी भी आपको color नजर आ रहे हैं red and blue. अब उन्होंने जो clean किया है, तो सिर्फ sketch के form में. अब वो मत. एक इधर सो वी कैन से कि जो जहांगीर के जाहिर है कि जहां नूरजहां बैठी रही हो वहां वो आर्टिस्ट अंदर अलाउड नहीं रहा होगा ऐसा नहीं रहा होगा कि इन लोगों ने पोज किया होगा आर्टिस्ट ने बनाया होगा इसीलिए गलती भी उसमें कर दी है उसने ये जो एक्चुअल जगह जहां पे अब है वो इन पैनल्स आर्टिस्ट के ऊपर किसी वक्त जब उस गार्डन में गया होगा तो उसको ये याद होगा कि यहाँ पे जीसस भी है और मैरी भी लेकिन बनाते वक्त उसको कंफ्यूजन हो गया उसने बजाय नेम उसके अंदर देने के उसको ऊपर शिफ्ट जरूर कर दिया लेकिन इट इज वेरी मच प्रेजेंट ताक के बजाय ताक के ऊपर उसने बना दिया लेकिन क्योंकि वहां पे मौजूद थे तो उसने बना दिया थर्ड एग्जाम्पल विच आई वुड गिव बिफोर आई एंड माय पेपर इज फ्रॉम द पीरियड ऑफ एंड दैट इज अगर पाचानामा आप जाके देखें जो छपा भी है बहुत बड़ी एक एग्जीबिशन ब्रिटिश म्यूजियम में हुई थी इट वॉज आई थिंक इन 2014 और समथिंग जिसमें एक उन्होंने पूरा एक वॉल्यूम छापा था इज विद अ वेरी इलस्ट्रेटेड पाचानामा विच इज नाउ प्रेजेंट उसमें जहां जहां पे भी दिल्ली फोर्ट डिपेक्ट किया गया है वहां का दीवाने आम डिपेक्ट किया गया है दीवाने आम के पिलर्स ग्रीन बनाए वो ग्रीन रखे देखिए अब आप जब जाइएगा तो वहां के ऊपर दीवाने आम में व्हाइट पिलर्स आपको नजर आएंगे। कौश ने, जैसे मैंने कहा कि कौश एक्चुअली हिस्टोरियन है शाहजहां के पीरियड की, उन्होंने कई आर्टिकल इसके ऊपर लिखे हैं और हर आर्टिकल में ये कहती हैं कि आइडियलाइज्ड है, शाहजहां के पीरियड में डीप ब्लू का इस्तेमाल है, गोल्डन का इस्तेमाल है, हर जगह वो पोस्टर देता है, अकबर को टेढ़ा दिखाई देता है, तो हर जगह आइडियलाइज्ड इफेक्ट है। यहाँ पे भी उसने, आर्टिस्ट ने उसको ग्रीन इफेक्ट डाल दिया क्योंकि ब्लू ब्लू इज डीप कलर ऑफ रॉयल्टी, उसको दिखाना था उसने डाल दिया। एक्चुअली तो बिल्डिंग ऐसी थी नहीं, क्योंकि बिल्डिंग तो वो आपके सामने मौजूद है जिसमें व्हाइट रंग का बना हुआ है। लेकिन अगेन मैं, और ये जो जितने भी पातशाहनामा पेंटिंग्स हैं उसमें जो ये पिलर्स दीवाने आम को दिखाए जा रहे हैं वो ग्रीन रंग के, हर जगह कई पेंटिंग्स, एक नहीं, पांच छह पेंटिंग्स है पूरे पातशाहनामा में और हर पेंटिंग में ग्रीन है। ये नहीं किया कि कहीं गोल्डन बना देता, कहीं लाल बना देता, कहीं सफेद बना देता, नहीं, हर एक में ग्रीन है। जबकि जब साइट पर जाइए तो जितने पिलर्स है सब व्हाइट है और मोटे मोटे हैं, ऐसे पतले नहीं है। सोर्सेस को जरा बारीकी से पढ़िए तब पता चलेगा कि जो शुरू में जो ये बनाया गया था ये इन द फॉर्म ऑफ तालाब, यूरेनियन कंसेप्ट दीवाने आम का था, जिसमें एक पवेलियन टाइप का बनाया जाता था, वुडन पवेलियन ऐवान, उसके पिलर्स जो थे वो वुडन हुआ करते थे और उस वुड के ऊपर इनेमल पॉलिश की गई थी। लेटर ऑन देवर कन्वर्टेड इंटू वाइट मार्बल। आर्टिस्ट जो बना रहा है वो ओरिजिनल बना रहा है जो एक्चुअली सीन पे मौजूद था, अब वो बाद में उसको उन्होंने स्टोन का बना के व्हाइट उस पर पेंट किया हुआ है, शाहजहां के पीरियड क्या हुआ है। लेकिन जो ओरिजिनल स्ट्रक्चर था, जो जिसका पूरा जिक्र लाहौरी में भी, बारिश में भी है, और वो तीसरा जो है कजवीनी में भी आपको जब देखेंगे तो उसमें जिक्र मिलता है कि इट वॉज रिनोवेटेड वंस अगेन और देवर ट्रांसफॉर्म इन टू सच फ्रॉम यू नो वुडन पवेलियंस देवर ट्रांसफॉर्म इन टू दी स्टोन वंस। दी पेंटिंग्स प्रिजर्व दिस इंफॉर्मेशन एंड हेयर देर इज एन एविडेंस हाउ दे एक्चुअली लुक लाइक। आई वुड ऑल्सो एंड बाय सेइंग कि पेंटिंग्स जो हैं वो एक तरीके से और यूज हो सकती हैं फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग द मेडिवल टेक्नोलॉजी। Now here is a painting which belongs to the 18th century. ये बंगाल की, इसमें इंडिगो प्रोडक्शन को डिपेक्ट किया गया है, जिसमें आप अगर देखेंगे तो ये इंडिगो वैक्स है, स्क्वायर, एक साइड ऊपर है, एक नीचे है, फर्नेस है, पर्शियन व्हील है, पानी लाया जा रहा है, फिर यहाँ बैलगाड़ियां हैं जिसपे दाब के ले जाया जा रहा है, इसके अंदर जो इंडिगो इस टाइप से प्रोसेस किया जाता था वो सारी के सारी चीजें मौजूद हैं। अगर आप जो रिमेन्स हैं इंडिगो वैट्स के, जो कॉलोनियल पीरियड के हैं, मुगल पीरियड के नहीं, कॉलोनियल पीरियड के जो रिमेन्स हैं, अगर आप उनसे आप कंपेयर किया, आई डोंट नो, हाँ फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये इसी आपके डिस्ट्रिक्ट की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, जब आप अलीगढ़ से आप आगरे की तरफ बढ़िएगा जहाँ टोल प्लाजा आता है, टोल प्लाजे प्लाजा से जस्ट पहले या बाद, आई एम फॉरगेटिंग, बिफोर टोल प्लाजा एक छोटा सा मंदिर बना हुआ है और मंदिर के पास में ये इंडिगो वैट्स। अगर आप इनके कंस्ट्रक्शन को देखें और इस सिवाय ये इसमें जाहिर है कि वो मैंने साइड नहीं लिया है जहां ऊपर फर्नेस वगैरह भी मौजूद थी, दी वाटर चैनल्स, the tanks at two levels, the same type of information here. For example, this is, you know, an indigo vat, which is a Mughal one. So, here circular vats are here. Here, British period ka tha. Lekin aap wo differences ko chhod dijiye aur dono ko mila dijiye. Ye jo photograph niche ki hai, ye Abakosh ki khechi hui hai, jo Sarhind. ये बंगाल, लेकिन जो प्रोडक्शन का तरीका होता था वो चाहे बंगाल में रहा हो चाहे इस रीजन में रहा हो, प्रोडक्शन का, मैन्युफैक्चर के जो इंडिगो का था तरीका, टेक्नोलॉजी वो वही थी, दोनों जगह उसी टाइप से डिपिक्टेड है। सो माय हम्बल सबमिशन इन दिस पेपर टू यू इज के पेंटिंग्स को सिर्फ आप ये मत समझ लें, कि ये सिर्फ आर्टिस्ट के लिए चीज है. कौन सा पिगमेंट इस्तेमाल किया गया था, कौन सा ब्रश इस्तेमाल किया गया था, वो फेस सीधा दिखाया गया था कि टू थर्ड दिखाया गया था, बैठे हुए दिखाया गया था कि खड़े हुए दिखाया गया था, वो आपका डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फाइन आर्ट्स है, वो उस पर काम करते रहेंगे, उनको करने देंगे. लेकिन जहां तक एज हिस्टोरियन आपका सवाल है, ये पेंटिंग्स आपको पास्ट के बारे में बहुत सी इंफॉर्मेशन देती हैं, जो रिटन सोर्सेज में बाज दफा मिल जाती हैं, बाज दफा इसमें भी आपको. लास्ट स्लाइड मैंने आपको दिखाई है, इसमें एक स्केची डिस्क्रिप्शन जरूर दिया हुआ है, पूरा रिकंस्ट्रक्शन उस चीज का इन पेंटिंग्स के जरिए ही हो सकता है. सो माय हंबल सबमिशन इज वेदर इट इज आर्किटेक्चर, द बिल्डिंग इटसेल्फ और द पेंटिंग, दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Both of them are material sources, and that is why I am presenting it in this, symposium on medieval archaeology. Both these sources, they are not written records, but they go to support and elaborate upon the written word. Abul Fazal ye detail nahi dega. Bahut se jo aur jo us period ke jo accounts hain, wo जाहिर है बाबर अगर लिख रहा है अपनी जिंदगी के बारे में लिख रहा है, वो बीच बीच में उसने थोड़ा बहुत तस्करा कर दिया, लेकिन दोस थिंग्स आर नॉट गिवन देयर. जो आर्टिस्ट जो बना रहा है, जो देखेगा वही बनाएगा. मैं बस लास्ट में एक एग्जांपल दे दूं, इफ्तिदार आलम खान साहब जिनके नाम पे हमने उस एग्जीबिशन को डेडिकेट किया है, वो क्लास में पढ़ाया करते थे अबाउट गन पाउडर. जो मैं MA के स्टूडेंट्स को भी पढ़ाता हूँ कि गन पाउडर बाबर के पीरियड में आ गया था कि नहीं आ गया था, कैनन थी कि नहीं थी, हैंड गन थी कि नहीं थी, वो अरण्यक पुराण के कुछ पेजेस मिलते हैं जो दिल्ली में नेशनल म्यूजियम में मौजूद हैं, जिसमें किले के पीछे जहाँ पे कृष्ण जी की फौजें लड़ रही हैं, वहाँ पे फोर्ट के वॉल के ऊपर दो कैनन दिखाए जाते हैं जो लोधी पीरियड के ग्राउंड हैं. वो आर्टिस्ट बता रहा है आपको महाभारत के पीरियड में, लेकिन आर्टिस्ट जो है वो महाभारत के पीरियड में नहीं रह रहा है, वो लोधी पीरियड में रह रहा है. और जिसने उसने अपने आसपास के एरिया में जो देखा है, जो वॉरफेयर का तरीका देखा है, वो बना रहा है. तो आर्टिस्ट को आप इतना लाइटली मत लीजिए, वो वही डिपेक्ट करता है जो एक्चुअली उसने देखा होता है. थैंक यू वेरी मच.